I've already added two clips here to the timeline. One is 6K, 30 frames per second. It's super laggy. I don't get any sort of smooth playback here. The first tips I have for you, we're gonna go ahead and open up the menus, the master settings. Now inside here, we can see our timeline resolution. You can actually just go ahead and set this to 1080p and then hit save. And as you can see now, look at how much smoother this is already. Alright, so another thing we can do is that we can go up here and hit playback at the top here. And when we go down to something called render cache, we can actually put this to smart. Now what happens now is that, as you can see, there's a red line that pops up here on top of the clip. When we have this on, it actually renders out the clip. So now you can see it's super smooth and it's ready to go. But this is not the method I prefer. We're gonna create something called proxies. So let's take this 6K25 clip right here and then go ahead and right click on that file in the media pool. And then you can come down to here, it says proxy media. And here you have an option called generate proxy media. And that is what we're going to do. But something you have to keep in mind when you're generating proxy files is also that it fills up your storage, because you are generating, you know, files on top of your original file. So go ahead and click the cogwheel down to the right, scroll down all the way to working folders. And here you can see something called proxy generation location. This is where your proxy files that we're going to generate is going to be saved on your computer. So this clip is originally a little above 1 gigabyte. So let's go ahead and right click this clip and scroll down to proxy media and then hit generate proxy media. So we generated a proxy from a 1 gigabyte file. It's actually 728 megabytes. So when you're done with your project, you can just go back and you can just delete the proxies. So now we have generated proxies for this file right here. In order to actually use the proxy file or to work with the proxy file, we're gonna have to go ahead and go up to playback here again. You can see here that we can either prefer camera originals, but we want to work with the proxies. So that's why we're gonna hit prefer proxies. And as you can see now down here, it goes from HQ to PXY, which stands for proxies. Now you can see it is buttery smooth for the playback. Even though I have done a grade, you can see that it's still pretty smooth with proxies. But if you experience, you know, lag with the grade on, you can hit this button up top right here, and this will actually bypass the color grades and fusion effects. And then you can just, you know, go back to editing without any issues. If you're still having issues with the lag, you can come up to playback. We can also go back to timeline playback resolution. And here we can actually put this to half or quarter. So we can use just a quarter of the actual resolution. And if you put this, you can see now how quality wise this is much worse. But again, that's not the purpose of the proxies. The proxies are here for you to get smooth playback so you can get through a nice edit without, you know, banging your head against the wall. You can actually also change the resolution of the proxies you're working with. So if you head into the cogwheel again and into the master settings, you can scroll down here and you can see what type of proxy media resolution you want to work with. Just by default, I think this is fine, and that's how I do it. So there you have it. If you found this video helpful, I would appreciate it if you could smash that like and subscribe button before you leave. All right, take care, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Have a good day.